The Chevy Nova, originally known as the Chevy II, was first introduced for the 1962 model year. To understand its story, you need to go back 2 years earlier. The year was 1960. It was the height of the Cold War. OPEC was formed. John F. Kennedy would defeat Richard Nixon in the presidential election. And Ford and Chevy released two small cars, the Falcon and the Corvair. The Nova owes its existence to these two cars. As the 1950s came to a close, the Big Three started to take notice of foreign automakers. Toyota, VW, Renault, and Fiat had started selling small cars in the U.S. Some consumers liked the smaller cars that they offered. Detroit needed an answer. Falcon filled this hole in the lineup for Ford, and Corvair for Chevrolet. The Corvair was a boldly engineered attempt at something entirely new. Development was overseen by Ed Cole, who had led the design of the original small block Chevy. Corvair was rear-engined and air-cooled. It had aggressive styling and was a relative success, but did not sell as well as the Falcon. The Falcon was created by Robert S. McNamara, an up-and-comer at Ford, who went on to serve as the Secretary of Defense. He wanted the car to be as light and simple as possible. Most of the parts were taken from the parts bin, and costs were kept down. This is the car that GM would emulate when designing the Nova. General Motors sold over 200,000 Corvairs, but Ford sold over 500,000 Falcons. This got GM scrambling to come up with a more conventional small car to compete with the Falcon. The answer was the Chevy II. Chevy II was developed in an 18-month period, and it borrowed heavily from the Falcon's design. There was a difference of 0.5 inch between their wheelbases. Both cars had the same basic look. After the Corvair, GM was not taking any chances with the Nova's design. There was nothing groundbreaking about the Nova like there was the Corvair, but the design worked. Nova would be a hit for almost 2 decades. The first generation Nova was produced from 1962 through 1965. This generation had the most body style options. It was available as a two-door sedan, hardtop, or convertible. As a four-door, it was available in both sedan or station wagon. When Nova first hit the market in 62, it was only available with a 153-cubic-inch inline four-cylinder engine or a 194-cubic-inch inline six. While the Nova SS was available in 1963, it was an appearance package and still came with the six-cylinder engine. In 1964, Chevy II got its first V8 option, the 283-cubic-inch small block. It was also the first year for Chevelle, which cannibalized some of Nova's sales. The Chevy II Nova was refreshed for the 1965 model year. It had many exterior refinements, including a new full-width grille, integrated headlight bezels, a new roofline for sedans, and more. 1965 saw Nova's largest available engine grow to 327 cubic inches. It put out 300 horsepower, giving it a better power-to-weight ratio than a lot of big block muscle cars. The second generation Nova had a two-year run for the 1966 and 67 model years. Generation 2 was inspired by the Supernova concept car. It was given a more elegant look, with a semi-fastback roofline and elegant curves while at the same time retaining its boxy shape. It was available as a two-door or four-door, hardtop, convertible, or station wagon. This generation is extremely desirable in the collector car market, particularly the Nova Supersport, with the 327 cubic inch small block that reached 350 horsepower. Sales of the 67 model were hurt by the introduction of the all-new Camaro, which had borrowed heavily from the third-generation Nova that would be released in 1968. Many of the parts are interchangeable between the two cars. GM was blindsided by the success of the Mustang. Borrowing from the Nova development team got the Camaro to market faster. The third generation Nova ran from 1968 through 1974. It completely threw away the boxy look of the previous two generations and replaced it with curvier fastback styling. 1968 was the last year for the Chevy II name, which is something GM had been working on phasing out for the last few years. The Nova convertible and station wagon were not carried into this generation, which left only a standard two-door coupe or sedan. There were more engine choices than ever. With the increased room between the fenders, Nova SS could now be had with a 295 horsepower, 350 cubic inch small block, or a 375 horsepower, 396 cubic inch big block from the factory. In 1970, Nova remained unchanged, with the exception of larger parking and side marker lights. 1970 was also the last year for the big block option. In 1969, a Chevy dealer named Don Yenko took advantage of GM's little-known central office production order program to order 38 Novas equipped with 427 cubic inch big block engines directly from the factory. In 1970, he ordered 175 LT1-equipped small-block Novas. These Yenko Novas are some of the most valuable vehicles in existence today and can command six figures at auction. For the most part, 1971 and 1972 were carryover models. They did get a popular new appearance package known as the Rally Nova. It added stripes that ran down the length of the car, as well as a Rally Nova sticker on the hood, rally wheels, and multi-leaf springs. In 1973, the Nova got a facelift. Large DOT-mandated bumpers were used, a hatchback was introduced, and the rear passenger windows were enlarged. In October of 73, the gas crisis hit. There were long lines at the filling stations, fuel was rationed, and prices soared. For the first time, Americans wanted small, fuel-efficient cars. This led to a spike in Nova sales in 1974. The six-cylinder model sold particularly well. Chevrolet introduced an all-new design for Nova in 1975. It had a boxier design that recalled the third-generation model. The fourth generation was the first to offer disc brakes as standard equipment, offered a smoother ride, quieter cabin, and improved visibility. The largest engine offered in this generation was the 350 cubic inch small block, which had been choked to 165 net horsepower by emissions regulations. As the 1970s came to a close, Nova soldiered on and GM released several luxury versions to try and compete with small German imports. They were known as the LN or Luxury Nova and the Concourse Nova. Sales for the Nova remained strong through the 1978 model year, but the writing was on the wall for Nova. Malibu and Monte Carlo were downsized in 1978. This led to too many options in the same size vehicle. Nova was discontinued after the 1979 model year and replaced with the Citation. The Nova name was briefly resurrected for the 1985 model year as a front-wheel drive subcompact. It was jointly developed by Toyota and GM and was a rebadged Toyota Corolla. This version of the Nova was produced until it was rolled into the Geo brand and rebranded as the Prism. This would be the final vehicle to carry the Nova nameplate. Nova was produced for 17 consecutive model years and always stayed true to the philosophy of providing reliable, efficient transportation at an affordable price. The Nova was so successful that it was copied by most of the GM lineup. Buick created the Apollo, Oldsmobile the Omega, and Pontiac the Ventura. These cars were rebadged Novas with different engine choices and refinements to justify their slightly higher price tags. A special few Novas became high-performance muscle cars. These versions of Nova are some of the most sought-after classic cars to this day. While it was considered a grocery getter in its day, a classic Nova will turn heads everywhere it goes. If you have or had a Nova, let us know about it in the comments section. Please consider subscribing and have a great day.